Hey there, everyone. Happy Tuesday. I am Shannon Milligan from RVA Home Team, powered by eXp Realty. And because it's Tuesday, we're going to talk about some buyer things. This can kind of go into the category of sellers too, but we are going to discuss the difference between dual agency, designated agency, and being an unrepresented buyer. So let's start with unrepresented buyer. Let's say you go into an open house and you start talking to the agent. If that is not your agent through a buyer agency agreement, then that is unrepresented buyer. You don't have an agent. Anything you tell that agent in that open house, they are obligated to tell the seller. So if you go in and you say, it's a great house, I would pay $10,000 more, they are obligated to tell the seller. That is you being an unrepresented buyer. And let's say you want to make an offer on that home and you don't have an agent, and you don't want an agent, then you will sign something called an unrepresented buyer agreement. And it says, hey, I know you're not my agent and I don't have an agent. And that means you have to do it all yourself. I don't recommend it. It's just not a good practice. It doesn't really cost you anything to have a buyer agent in most instances. So make sure you get yourself a buyer's agent, because otherwise unrepresented, you walk into that open house and the person hosting that open house has to tell that seller everything that you've just said. So that's unrepresented buyer. Now, let's say that you go into that open house and you decide to hire that agent and you happen to put an offer in on a property that that agent has listed. So let's say that was me and you came in and you say, Shannon, I want you to be my agent. Okay, great. We're going to sign a buyer agency agreement. And let's say it is my listing. Well, because I'm representing both the seller and the buyer, I have to go into a dual agency, which means I represent both of you and I have to become like neutral. So you as the buyer, you say to me, Shannon, how much more should I offer when multiple bid? I can't advise you of that. The seller says to me, Shannon, how much should we accept? I can't advise them. I have to become neutral. I really do not like dual agency. It's very rare that we do that around here. Sometimes we'll do it with an investment property because investors know what they're doing on the buyer side and the sellers don't care. But in a standard normal transaction, I highly recommend you do not engage in a dual agency. And I highly recommend that you don't be an unrepresented buyer. Your best interest as a buyer is to go in a buyer agency agreement with your buyer agent. So that was unrepresented buyer and that was dual agency. Designated agency is when I work for eXp Realty. There are about 86 agents in the Richmond area that work for eXp Realty. So let's say I go to you and I as a buyer, we go into a house that is listed by another eXp Realty agent and you want to write an offer. We have to sign something called a designated agency agreement. That just says, hey, Mr. and Mrs. Buyer, Shannon works for you and she's with eXp Realty and Joe Smith works for eXp Realty and they represent the seller. So designated is really not that big of a deal because we all work as independent contractors. So I'm representing your best interest and the listing agent is representing their seller's best interest. So that is the difference between the three different unrepresented buyer. Be very careful when you go into those open houses because again, anything you tell the agent, they are obligated to go and tell the seller, even if it's not that agent's listing. So sometimes other agents will hold open houses for fellow agents. So let's say it's Joe Smith's listing, but I'm holding it open. Even if you come in and you tell me, even though I don't technically represent the seller because I'm not the listing agent, I still represent the seller and have to tell them anything you say because it's you're an unrepresented buyer. So I highly recommend that you look for a buyer agent who's going to look after your best interests. And that's where you get a buyer agency agreement. And that's where you come in and you say, Shannon, I want to hire you. I want you to be my buyer agent. Great. Then I represent you. Now, if you want to buy one of my listings, so you say, okay, Shannon, I hired you but I like one of your listings, but I don't want to be in dual agency. What do I do then? I will refer you to another agent so that you have your best interests covered. And if you really want to buy my listing, then we can do that. Unless you're okay with dual agency, but I really don't recommend it. So if you have any questions about agency, please feel free to put it in the comments. I'm happy to answer it. Or if you're a little shy, we do get some people that don't want to air everything out in the comments, send me a message and I'm happy to explain agency to you. All right, guys, I hope you have a wonderful Tuesday. I'm getting ready to, it's 3 o'clock. At 4 o'clock, we are shooting a video for a new listing that we have coming on live on Thursday in Salisbury. I'll hope you will turn in for that video that we're doing. We will put that out on Thursday as well because, well, I have costumes, y'all. And I'm kind of excited for this listing and this video. All right, everybody, have a wonderful week. I will see you on Thursday for seller tips.